Hey, Architect Nation, Enoch Sears here, and in this Architect CEO memo, we're going to talk about the parable of the golf ball and how to get what you want out of life. So, Enoch Sears here, publisher and founder of Business of Architecture, and as I was walking a couple days ago, I came across this golf ball that literally was in my lawn. Now, I live right next to a golf course. There's a street, there's a row of houses, and there's the golf course, right? So what happened and how did this golf ball, it says Titleist 4, get on my lawn? Well, it's very rare that we get golf balls this far, but apparently what happened is someone was driving the golf ball, it went way off course and it landed in my yard. Now, it had to be pretty off course to get in my yard. And then here is how this parable relates to the game of life and the game of business. When we're younger and we start out, we have dreams and we have visions, and then most people somewhere along the way, they end up someplace completely different than where they thought they would end up. And for many people, this is okay. But for many people, they look back and they wish and they wonder what they did wrong. Could they have achieved more in their life? What happened to the dreams they set when they were younger, the passion and the vision that they ultimately had? So they end up beat up, they end up feeling just totally overwhelmed about life, and they lose the focus on the vision that got them started and that they originally had that really brought that passion into their life. And so what I would have you consider today, to get what you want out of life, you need to be, number one, clear on what it is exactly that you want. Now, this is very, very difficult. It's even hard for me because what we want always changes. Ultimately, what most people want is they want a good feeling. But most people don't know the difference between planning today, like getting a good feeling today, and then doing something hard today that's going to give you a great feeling 10 years in the future. So as human beings, unfortunately, we're very, very short-sighted. We're just looking at the things that are happening today. And so this rolls over into our business where we're running back and forth. We're being in reactionary mode, running from fire to fire, instead of being intentional, setting the vision, setting targets, and going out to achieve them. So just like the golf ball went off course, right? This person was probably aiming in the right direction, but let's just say that this person wasn't really intentional about where they wanted this golf ball to go. Now, there's a number of reasons why this golf ball ended up in my yard. It could be that the person is just a sucky golfer like I am and they have no control of the ball. It could be that they were just playing around. It could be that it hit a tree. It could be that it hit an obstacle and bounced off course, right? I don't know why this golf ball, or maybe someone was driving their golf cart by and it just rolled off and fell into my yard. But here's the key. When we look at what you want to get out of life, one of the key and central ingredients, as I mentioned, number one is casting the vision, knowing exactly where you want to get. And then number two is setting the target and tracking the target, right? Setting a target. So let me ask you a question. In your business, do you have specific targets that you're working for in your business? If you're an architect or design firm owner, do you have a specific revenue billings number that you're looking to achieve? Do you have a number of client outreach, you know, business development activities that you're looking to hit? Do you know the metrics in your business, like your multiplier, like your utilization rate, like your revenue per full-time employee, right? These are the dashboard of your business, and they all combine along with your vision to be able to get you where you want to go. So what I would invite you today to ask yourself and answer the question, where in my business do I not have a target? And so I'm going to potentially just be reactive and end up someplace that I don't want to be. What could I do to be more intentional about where I want to get by focusing in on a specific goal and then implementing day after day after day to achieve it? Now, if you're ready to take your architecture firm to the next level, I want to remind you that this episode is sponsored by the Dream Practice Accelerator. You can find out more and watch a free 60-minute presentation on building your architecture firm into your dream practice. And this isn't just theory, it actually has real case studies of architects, small architecture firm owners, perhaps not too unlike yourself, that have been able to free up their time, been able to focus on what they love by maximizing their firm to deliver three key ingredients. I call these the three Fs: freedom, fulfillment, and finances. So if that sounds interesting, go check it out. Go to dreampracticewebinar.com and I'll see you on the other side. As always, this is Enoch signing off. Carpe diem, and be careful where you send your golf ball.